I'm Sanjana and this is time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it.
Shaka everyone and welcome to another brand new episode. This episode is really special because I'm going to share with you some tips and tricks on how you can do up your room or your workspace. I'm going to share with you 5 cool, different, simple ideas that can convert any room from good to super. So get ready, because it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Okay, as you can see, I have this old wooden chair. So first, let's just wipe it so that all the dust is off, and then we can give it a nice clean coat of acrylic colors. All right, let's prepare the second coat. I'm using blue. Okay, our paint is ready. Now I'll show you our magic ingredient. And here's our magic ingredient. This is white glue. As you guys can see, I'm applying a coat of glue. And on top of that, before it dries, I'm applying a coat of blue color. So what happens is, as the glue starts to dry, it separates and it creates cracks. So the blue coat on top of glue starts to separate as well. And then you can see the red from the bottom, and that creates a nice distressed look. And this is how you can convert a boring chair into a nice vintagey distressed chair. Oops. All right, let's make a string art poster. Here's a sheet of paper. I'll take a marker and sketch something. I am making a robot here. Now, the second step is we need a wooden board. Now we'll place our sketch on this. Then with the help of tape, just stick it in place. So here I have nails and I have a hammer. And once you're done with this, you can take the sketch out, pick up some colorful strings of wool, and then we'll just make our pattern and design. And every time you go around the nail, just turn it once and then move to the next one. So first we'll form an outline. So outline is done and now I'm going to create a pattern. So I'll take the wool from one end and go to a different section. What you can do is you can break up your artwork into different sections and then choose a particular color for each section. All right, let's finish the mouth. I'm using this light pink for the mouthpiece. Let's see if it goes well with the red robot. And we are done, finally. Look at that. And this is how you mix 70s string art style with some futuristic design. Looks super, right? This will look beautiful on my wall. I'm gonna go put it up. All right, let's make a vintage storage trunk. As you can see, I have a metal trunk here. So to coat this, we need paint. Let's get in the paint. All right, so we have paints here. I'm using acrylic colors to paint this. But because I'm going to make it a little leathery, I'm going to use this nice brown shade, paint a coat with a brush. And after that, I'm just using a sponge and dabbing it so that you get this grainy texture. And once it dries, I'm going to do another coat and repeat the process with the sponge. Okay, looks like we are done. Now I'm going to add some stripes on the side. All right, we are done with the stripes. And once that is ready, you can put some stickers on it or write something on it to make it look more sort of classy and vintage-like. All right, so you can see I have some printouts here. Now, with the help of glue, we are going to just stick them in place. And with that, we are done. And you can see how we have converted an old metal trunk into a cool vintage leather-like storage unit. Looks fantastic, right? Hiya! Let's begin. Okay, we are making a PVC pipe lamp. Now I'm cutting this with a hacksaw. Now for my animal shape, I need a body and four legs. So we'll cut all the pieces. All right, so we have all the pieces. Let's start the assembly. So first I'll take the body and using this four-way piece like that. And the same thing we'll do for the back. There you go. So the body is ready. And now we need to attach the legs. So using the L joint, but you can see that these two are the same size. So for this, you need some smaller pieces to attach the legs. Time to saw some more pipe. Okay, so we have some more pieces. Now we'll just put one in and attach the L joint. Look at that. And now you can attach the leg like this. Now same thing we'll do on the other side. So for the head, I'm using a bulb holder with the bulb, which will become the head of our animal. Look at that. Now you can clearly see the form. But before we attach the head, we need to attach the cable. But before we attach it to the holder, we need to pass the wire through the animal's body so that it comes to the head. Open the pieces so the wire comes out. There you go. Now you can see because I've passed the wire through the leg, it's coming in the way of the balance of the leg. So what I'll do is, I'll just make a small slit here. And there you go. Now we'll attach the wire to the bulb holder. And with that, we are done. Okay, everything is in place. Now let's paint this and complete the whole form. Now to paint this, I'm using acrylic colors. I'm painting with a sponge and brush. Okay, so the painting is done. And I'm pretty happy with the paint job. All right, the horns are in place and my stag is ready. Let's attach the head. Our light bulb looks pretty good. Let's check how it looks when it comes on. I'll plug this. Alright, let's begin. So to make bookends, you need material that is heavy or has some weight because it has to hold the weight of the books. So I have these wooden blocks here. So first, let's stick these pieces together. Now I have white glue here. And now place the piece on top. Alright, this is done. And we'll do the same thing for the other one. So we can move this aside. Keep it for drying. So while this is drying, let's figure out how to make these bookends look more Game of Thrones-like. Now we are going to cut this out cleanly. All right, we are done and our cutout is ready. Look at that. Now using this direwolf as a template, you need to trace and cut 2 out of boxboard and 2 out of cardboard. Okay, so first we'll work with the cardboard cutouts. So we need to stick these pieces together. Don't apply any glue to the bottom half of these cutouts. Align them properly. We'll paint this black. You have to paint on both sides like this and make sure you cover every corner. And once you're done, you can keep it aside for drying. Okay, while our cardboard is drying, let's work on the box board. So I'm gonna use a permanent marker and draw the direwolf on this. Okay, I'm done with the outline. Now using a cutter, I'm going to make some grooves so that this cutout looks slightly more 3D. Now we'll use glue and stick this on our cardboard piece. Now you have to do the same thing for the other side. Okay, time to paint the bookends. This is acrylic color. I've mixed black and white, so I got some nice gray. And we are going to coat this on the wood. Okay, I've painted the bookends in a nice flat gray. Now let's add some grainy texture. So I'm using some white and some black. Okay, the bookends are done. I've given this stone granite kind of effect on it. Let's keep them aside and do the same effect on the wolf. Okay, we are done. Now we'll just pull apart the two pieces. And when you're sticking it, make sure it's in the middle of the bookend. And you have to do the same thing for the other one as well. And with that, your Game of Thrones bookends are now ready. Check it out. I hope all these ideas and tips will help you do up your room better. If you have any more ideas or suggestions or feedback, then write in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And if you make any of these things, then please click pictures and post them on my Facebook page. I would love to see them. I'll see you next time. Until then, be good and do good. Peace.